What is up, Renaissance crew? I'm the original Renaissance man, Devon DaVinci, and you're watching DaVinci Reacts. Today I'm going to be reacting to a video that means a lot to me. It's a game that I've been waiting over a decade for. I remember the teaser at the end of Kingdom Hearts 2, released way back in, when was it, like 2005? It's been a long time, but it's slowly starting to, you know, approach, and I can't wait for the game to come out. This is Kingdom Hearts 3 opening movie trailer. So I don't know if this is going to be the opening cinematic that a lot of these Square Enix games tend to have. If it is, it could be interesting because it should shine a light on the, at least a little bit more on like story elements. Now, I've already told you guys I'm not big on Kingdom Hearts story. I mostly play it for the fan service and for the music. I love the music in these games. And let's go ahead and jump in and see what it has to offer. Is that Riku? It might be a new character, I'm not sure. I know them. Should I take a leave? Taste what a bitter sweet. All my, now that's Riku and Kairi. Okay. I forgot all the bad guys' names. I just know it has an X in it. There's an X somewhere in there. I know that. Right, I remember that. That was 365 days, I believe it's called. 350, something like that. I did play it. Goofy and Donald. And Mickey. I cannot wait until this game comes out, and it's almost here. It's less than 2 months away. All these years have been waiting for this game to come out, and it's less than 2 months away. I cannot wait. I will be streaming this game on launch, so be sure to stick around on your Twitch, YouTube, because I will be streaming this game opening day, opening night. As soon as it comes out, I will be playing it. Like I said, I love Kingdom Hearts. I love the fan service that it has, the Final Fantasy characters that appear in it, the worlds from Disney. Realizing what worlds are in it. When I first played, I'm not going to look at any type of walkthroughs or videos trying to give out tips or anything like that, because one of the things that I find the most joy out of when it comes to Kingdom Hearts is figuring out which Disney worlds are going to be in the game. And I don't want that spoiled, so I'm going to go ahead and only figure out what Disney worlds are going to appear after I've already gotten through the game. So as I get through the game, I will slowly realize what the worlds are going to be. I'm just hoping that there's not a lot of repeat worlds. I know sometimes Kingdom Hearts tends to have their go-to worlds. Like, usually they always have Mount Olympus, usually they always have Agrabah, usually they always have Halloween Town. Like, those are the things that are given. And I mean, despite the fact that I haven't played Kingdom Hearts in a long time, I'm kind of over them. I understand why Mount Olympus is in, because it has an entirely separate function than just being a world that you have to, you know, clear the Heartless out of. It usually has some type of Colosseum feature that has something to do with the game as well, so I can understand that. But the other worlds, I would like to see them swipe them out and put some new worlds in. I've already said this. I want to see them, and I'm pretty sure they already well, pretty sure I know for a fact that all the worlds that they planned on putting in are already in the game. But I would love to see a Marvel or a Star Wars world. I mean, they're owned by Disney now. I would love to see Sora and Goofy and Donald like appearing with the Avengers, or them appearing with Rey and the other Star Wars band. And I want to see Sora get a Keyblade lightsaber, something that incorporates those two elements. I want to see Sora with some type of weapon that's inspired by the Avengers. Maybe it could be like Thor's hammer, or it could be like or Goofy can get something like Captain America's shield. Maybe Donald can get Scarlet Witch's, or some type of weapon from Scarlet Witch, even though she don't use a weapon. Donald is a mage user, so, or magic user, so it would kind of fit his character to get something from her. Like, there's a ton of things they could do with this. I'm just hoping that they don't just like go generic with it and pretty much make this Kingdom Hearts that we've already seen, but like a high definition version of it. I do have a little bit of faith in Square Enix. They haven't really done anything huge lately. Final Fantasy 15 was cool. I did like Final Fantasy 15. But I'm to tell the truth, they haven't really like blown me away since Final Fantasy 10. Like, ever since then, like, everything else is just kind of, you know, it kind of lost that Final Fantasy feel to it. Like, I remember, like, to me, and I'm about to sound like an old-ass person, but to me, back in the day when I used to play Final Fantasy 7, even 8, and 9, it was just like this, you can get sucked into the world of the game, and you just, like, felt everything about it, the music, the gameplay, the characters, all that, like, just drew you in. And then now recently it's like, I don't know, I just can't really get into it. Maybe Final Fantasy 15 would have been better if they had more than just four main characters that you had from the very beginning. Because one of the things I liked about Final Fantasy also was getting to picking up characters as your journey went along. Like, you started off with maybe one or two characters, and then after the first part of the game, you get another character, and then somewhere on the journey, you get a fourth character, and then a fifth, sixth, seventh, and then by the end of the game, you got this band of characters that you would like swap in and out of and change around, and you would like, you know, pretty much working with your layout until you have a team that's like catered to your play style. Then usually towards the end of the game, they will have some type of ending boss that you have to fight, that where you have to use all your characters, and like you have to split them up in like three parties or something like that. Usually that's how it always works. Anyway, that's been his reaction. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, make sure you hit that like button, subscribe, and share. Let me know what your Kingdom Hearts memories are, if you have a favorite world, if you have a favorite moment, if you have... I don't know, if you've been waiting for this game for a long time, let me know when the last time you played Final Fantasy, or not Final Fantasy, the last time you played Kingdom Hearts 2, or the first time you played Kingdom Hearts 2, and you saw that spoiler at the end. Like, how long have you been waiting for this? Have you been waiting for it like me? I remember waiting for it when Kingdom Hearts 2 first launched. Anyway, that's been this video. I'm going to go ahead and move on to something else. I'm going to go ahead and give you the deuces also. I'm the original Renaissance Man, Devon DaVinci, signing out. Deuces.